A lot of reaction is coming in from parents and teachers, especially here in Peel and Toronto, the so-called COVID hot zones. And with new variants of the virus at play, going back to class in less than 2 weeks from now is something that is weighing very heavily on many families who just want to do what's best for their kids.
Well, are you ready to get your son back in school?
You know, it's a tough question.
It's been a challenging time, to say the least, for parents and kids who have been juggling the back and forth of online learning. Carrie, a mother of two, is also a high school teacher and tells me she's been in a constant state of anxiety while thinking about what comes next.
What I think is best for my family in terms of their safety is to stay home. What I think is best for my child in terms of mental health is to go back to school. And I can't really find a way around those. And I know everyone's trying to juggle and find a way to marry those two options.
Anne is in the same position. She also teaches high schoolers while at home with her two young boys.
Overall, it's been hard.
Do you feel the government has done enough to keep the school community safe?
I think on paper, what they said they're going to do sounded amazing. However, in September, we didn't see a lot of the things that they said were going to happen.
As a teacher, would you feel safe going back into the classroom?
Not really. Do I think that hiring more teachers and making sure that we're able to follow public health advice in terms of distancing and PPE and all that sort of stuff is important? Absolutely. It's our children's lives that are, you know, being considered.
Weighing the risks and the benefits of returning to the classroom is a common thread among the parents I've spoken to. Dana is also a mother of two. She's been running a small business from home while coaching her seven-year-old through virtual learning.
We have a lot of friends and kids that are in therapy now that weren't before, that have developed anxiety problems that they didn't before, that are regressing both academically and emotionally. I've definitely laid awake at night wondering, is this new variant or these new maybe faster spreading variants going to now work its way through our communities? But I'm not concerned enough to sacrifice the mental health of the kids.
Now, the two teachers I did speak with today, they would really like to see vaccines for educators as soon as healthcare workers and long-term care residents receive their doses. And both are pleased with the expansion of rapid testing in schools, but are a little apprehensive as to how it will all work.